So my name's Justin Jones. I've been in the film industry as a cinematographer for about 10 years now. Brandon from Aperture hit me up and he said, hey Justin, we got the 12 light kits in. Would you be interested in a shoot day where you can basically do whatever you want to really test out these lights? They're really kind of in the lane of like tube lights, you know what I mean? Like stuff you can see in frame, but you can also use them as sources as well. We had this really cool setup in the bunker. Since they're magnetic, it's really cool because the bunker set here at BMLA is all metal corrugated walls. So you can place those lights literally anywhere. And inside the bunker, we have an office and there's a window in that office with a bunch of bullet holes. So I thought, why don't we kind of trace out that window with the MCs and do a chase sequence of like fire kind of flashing around that. And then we have our talent sitting in and then we shined the 300D with a spotlight mount through those bullet holes. So we had a combination of like shafts of light coming through, also with the MCs kind of chasing that. That was probably one of my favorite shots. One of the setups when we were, when we had our talent against the brick wall, and we had this happy accident of these shifting shadows. The reason that happened was because we had 8 MCs lined up on the bench in front of her. As they were going off, we had them in a chase sequence. So they, you know, from right to left, they would, one would go off, 2, 3, 4, 5. And as they would do that, each one obviously creates a shadow. So all of a sudden we had a key light on her. We shut off the key light, which brought up that shadow a lot more. And you just see the shadow shifting back in the background, which is going opposite of the chase sequence, which was really cool. Yeah, I think the next best thing would be creating a chase sequence with like 120s or 300s or something like that. So having that small of a light that you could just pop out of a case is just epic. The Nova and the MCs are very compatible. You almost can't tell the difference between the quality of light. Obviously, one's bigger, it'll be softer. When you put the little rubber diffusions on them, it creates a great quality of light. So we had the Nova panel at the top of this metal ladder inside the warehouse, and then we lined the sides with the MCs. First off, to have them both on the Sidus Link app is awesome because you could switch back and forth matching your colors, or if you're trying to do complementary colors or whatever it is, it's just very easy to switch back and forth. All being in the same universe really brings it all together. So let's think of kind of real world scenarios, right? Where you would need to add an effect to sell off a look in a film, right? Especially more narrative work. We had a TV in the bunker office room and it's not giving off too much light. So in the Magic program, they have a record option where you can record the kind of flicker or pulsing or anything of a light. So we recorded the television screen and sent that to 4 MCs that we had just out of frame, which gave her the exact same flicker that was coming out of that TV, which completely sold the effect. And I don't know, literally, I don't know another way that we could have pulled that off in that amount of room, because we're in such a small confined space. So being able to record like the TV static and recreate that is mind blowing. And it actually worked, and the footage that we got from it was absolutely gorgeous. And I'm actually excited to see it. So please show me. I feel like the biggest challenge in lighting any set in general is having lights that are, first off, battery powered. A lot of locations that you have, or if you're doing run and gun stuff, you don't really have places to plug stuff in. So that was a really big limitation up until these new battery powered little lights came in, the MC being one. I can use the MC kit on set because it just gives me the flexibility to get light anywhere, any confined space. I use them in cars all the time. Cars are like the best, especially the 12 light is, it comes with so many. And a lot of times I've had, you know, the 4 light kit or just one and the battery will die. So having the 12 light kit gives me a lot of flexibility to switch lights out and make sure that something's charging at all times. The MCs being RGB is also another game changer, especially in the small lighting world. So I guess you would say my style would be, you know, colorful and using a lot of complementary and contrasting colors to really bring a scene to life. With the MCs, it's extremely simple. I can probably, to be honest with you, light an entire video with just a 12 light kit. It's actually, that'd be a great challenge. I should try that. I don't need gels anymore. I can straight just use the MCs to add color anywhere I need. I feel like the thing I want people to take away from it the most is that they can basically do anything with the kit. You know, the world is your oyster. You can do, like I said, chase sequences down a hallway. You can hide them behind a light. Also having the Magic program and being able to basically do whatever you can imagine. Chase sequences, fires, cop cars, having multiple lights and multiple sources from different directions.